Good afternoon, and welcome to the NBA Draft Lottery.
I remember driving up that day from Philadelphia. It was a long, long Sunday, I remember. There were 11 people there representing teams that had smuggled in a jersey with O'Neal on the back of it.
The 11th pick goes to the Houston Rockets.
As the lottery kept coming down, I will never forget the pressure that was building, simply because everybody knew what Shaquille O'Neal had the potential of doing for any franchise.
The third pick in the 1992 NBA draft goes to the Minnesota Timberwolves.
I remember going to a sports bar, and we had our people at just a couple of tables, and all of a sudden that thing started coming down closer and closer, and you could feel the adrenaline and the excitement just rising.
The second pick in the 1992 NBA draft goes to the Charlotte Hornets. And that means that the Orlando Magic will pick first in the 1992 NBA draft.
With the first pick in the 1992 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic selects Shaquille O'Neal from Louisiana State University.
Shaquille O'Neal's entrance into the NBA was one of the most celebrated in all of sports. Already one of the game's most well-known players before he ever stepped onto an NBA court, Shaq was greeted in Orlando with a celebration of historic proportions.
Orlando Magic, could you hold please? We've been bombarded with tons of calls.
Yes, these all have to deal with Shaquille.
We never expected the excitement and the attention and the hype.
Jack, will I please have an autograph, please?
Yeah! Literally overnight, we went from being an expansion team to having the marquee player in the league.
Who'd you guys come to see tonight?
Shaquille!
And as the season began, Shaq would soon become a national phenomenon.
In the first NBA rookie to be named Player of the Week, his first 7 days in the league, Shaquille O'Neal is playing even better in his second week.
Good pass to Sykley, and the dunk is turned back by O'Neal. A major league block by Shaquille. Oh! Look out!
He's the guy, the new kid on the block. I mean, it's like when Magic came in, and then when Jordan came in, and now Shaquille. He's going to be great for the league.
Williams rejected O'Neal!
Big time block.
He's going to be one of those guys that can carry a team, a franchise.
O'Neal runs the floor, takes it all the way.
He's a very amazing talent, and I think he's the future of the NBA.
O'Neal, another rebound. He has gone after him with a vengeance. No-look feed, Dennis Scott. No-look feed from the big fella.
Only the fifth rookie starting center in NBA All-Star history. Gee, who could that be?
You know him simply as Shaq. From the Orlando Magic, Shaquille O'Neal.
The fact is, Shaquille O'Neal is the next megastar in the NBA.
Slate.
Okay, quiet, please.
Roll him.
Rolling.
Action.
It's all real. He's the one right now. From Shaquille for real.
O'Neal, diving, saving. You gotta love that effort. We call him Shaq. Shaquille O'Neal.
Even as a rookie, Shaq made his impact felt like few athletes had ever managed before him.
Shaquille, hold on to the roof! The Shaq attack!
Oh my. Having led all rookies in scoring, shooting percentage, rebounding, and blocks, Shaquille O'Neal today won Rookie of the Year Award. 96 votes to 2.
When I retire and have children, I can tell my son, son, I was bad. I was bad.
Did you know children are dying because of AIDS?
Did you know a child is orphaned every 15 seconds?
Every 15 seconds.
AIDS is devastating children and young people's lives around the world.
Millions.
Millions.
Millions are losing parents, teachers, brothers, and sisters.
Children are lacking the knowledge they need to keep themselves safe.
They need your support.
Basketball is just a game. This is real life for millions of children.
UNICEF works in over 150 countries to stop the devastation of AIDS.
We can create a better future.
Take the step now.
Unite for children.
Unite for children.
Unite for children. Unite against AIDS. Devastating children and young people's lives around the world.
Millions are losing their parents, teachers, brothers, and sisters.
They need medicine, food, education, and protection.
UNICEF works in over 150 countries
to stop the devastation of AIDS.
We can create a better future.
Unite for children, unite against AIDS.
With only 1 year of his professional career behind him, Shaquille had become more than a superstar. He was a phenomenon. He had made a rap album, starred in a movie, endorsed an incredible array of products, and was known all over the world. At only 21 years of age, he handled it all as if he'd been preparing for it all of his life. And in a sense, he had. Even as a child, he was in many ways getting ready for his extraordinary future. The son of an Army sergeant, Shaq got an early taste of life on the road.
You just sort of moved place to place, went to different schools, have different friends, different coaches. You really couldn't keep a lot of friends.
Because you would know when they would be leaving or when you would be leaving.
And standing 6'9" tall at age 13, he didn't blend in easily in new situations.
He was always self-conscious of his size. Tall as he was the biggest thing in the classroom. And he always would like slump down and walk with his head down a little bit.
Shaquille, he was very awkward. And you know, kids can be cruel, very cruel, because the name calling is gonna come because you're different than the average child.
But Shaquille would eventually find a friend he could rely on, no matter how often his family moved.
Spider-Man. Cartoons, because every Saturday morning, cartoons. No school, so you get up and watch cartoons.
I used to like climb on roofs and act like I was Spider-Man, and when our fame was out, I used to dance around the house.
Shaquille wanted to be a fame dancer one time. They had a little cardboard thing they put out in the back. They go out there doing the cardboard and do all this kind of stuff, and man, he could do it real good. He could do it real good.
But Shaquille's antics weren't confined to his home.
We had a conference in school. Shop teacher said, one day Shaquille's on the ground doing a break dance. He was spinning on the floor on his back and spinning up and dancing and shaking and everything. I said, hold it, Shaquille, come on, let's go. I want to talk to you from there.
At first, he did a lot of things that weren't necessary, like, you know, you do things to make children like you, so he wanted to be a class clown. We had to teach him, when you go to school, you go to learn, and there's a time and a place for this.
His parents not only offered him discipline and advice, however, they also helped him find a suitable outlet for his ample energy.
I started teaching him basketball, and he was tall staying on the team then. And that helped a little bit because he would see how his height was to his advantage of everybody else.
But though Shaquille was willing, at first he was not particularly able.
My freshman year, I didn't make the team. I wasn't too good, so I had to play DYA. That stands for Dependent Youth Activities. That's for like the younger kids who didn't make the high school team.
But Shaquille's basketball career took a fateful turn when he attended a clinic given by Louisiana State University coach Dale Brown.
After the clinic was over, I asked Coach Brown, I said, look, I'm 6'9", I need help, I can't dunk. And he reached in his bag and he pulled out some Nautilus equipment. And he looked at me. How long you been in the Army? I said, I'm not in the Army, I'm only 13.
13? Where's your father?
and he met my father, and he kept writing me. I just kept playing, kept practicing. I got my first dunk in the game. My confidence was just raised to another level. I knew that I can do it.
Over the following year, Shaquille's confidence and ability continued to grow. His family would move again, this time to San Antonio, but now nothing was going to slow Shaq down. From the moment he stepped on the court, Shaq was an instant sensation. Averaging over 30 points and 20 rebounds a game, he made Cole High School one of the best teams in the state.
Coach Maduro, the basketball coach, he had a one rule: get the ball to Shaq. If you don't want to get him the ball, then come sit with me on the sideline.
In his 2 years, Shaq would lead the Cougars to a 72-1 record and be named a high school All-American.
Gary, it's bye-bye to the Sean Elliotts, the Danny Ferries, and the Stacey Kings. But hello, everybody, Shaquille O'Neal.
Here's Shaquille with another injection.
He'll take it out of the way. Oh, I can't believe it. That's a seven-footer. Are you serious? I really believe, without a doubt, Shaquille O'Neal has to be the best high school player in the United States.
Shaquille was amazing. You know, Coach Moore and I would sit on the sidelines during a game, just grabbing each other's arms, going, God, did you see that? I can't believe that.
A now confident Shaquille handled his new star status with ease.
What's been the secret to Cole's success this year?
Well, secret is me blocking shots and getting rebounds and making my shots well. That's the secret.
Reveling in all the attention, Shaquille fully enjoyed the role of local hero.
He was one that was going to be a part of everything, and that's why I say he helped me out during the football season. He was my statistician. He walked the sidelines and scared the hell out of the opponents.
I went out into the gym, and I was jabbing around with him out there, and he just picks me up and just presses me up over his head and just holds me up there. It's probably the most helpless feeling I've ever had in my life, but it's all in good fun, and he always kid around these older kids, took care of the younger kids. And he really took lots of things on his shoulders to make this a little bit better place to be.
In his senior year, Shaq would give Cole a parting gift, a state championship. It was the perfect end to his triumphant stay in San Antonio. And now he was ready to move on. In 1989, 4 years after he met Coach Dale Brown, Shaquille arrived at LSU as one of college basketball's hottest recruits, but joining a team that returned two future NBA first-round picks, Chris Jackson and Stanley Roberts, Shaq had to wait his turn for the spotlight.
In high school, my role was to rebound, score, block shots, but when I got there, my role had changed, and I had accepted that. And then the next year, Chris left early, and Stan had an academic problem, so I was all by myself.
Shaq knew his time had arrived.
Oh, fill it up, Shaq!
And he was ready.
Oh, what a pass! Oh!
Good fake by O'Neal.
Oh, scooty! Shaq, you're unbelievable!
In his sophomore season, Shaq would immediately become the country's most dominant player.
He's going to take it right at Shaquille.
Blocked by
away, baby.
Capturing Player of the Year honors, he would now gain national attention.
Shaq slam!
Oh, my goodness, are they going crazy? That was serious!
That ought to make the ESPN plays of the week.
Oh, man, alive! Oh!
Shaq had become college basketball's biggest attraction, and as the media descended, he welcomed them as if they were long-lost friends.
In high school, I was used to the media coverage, so it wasn't that new to me. I just took it in the same perspective. City media coverage, national media coverage, you just have to, you know, do the same things.
Happy birthday to me.
And as he had in high school, Shaq enjoyed every minute of his celebrity.
I saw his playfulness after he came. He's a playful guy. He's a big old gentle giant, really. I can remember going into his dorm room and he'd be doing that deal they do with their records and spinning and doing stuff with the headsets on. He'll see a game at a fraternity. He'll stop his car and get out and play with the guys.
But while Shaq made the most of his college days, basketball experts turned their attention to his NBA prospects.
Throughout his sophomore year, speculation started to grow. Will this be it? Will he turn pro after this year? But he liked college. It was a good time for him.
What's up, man?
But in his third season, Shaq would be introduced to the less enjoyable side of stardom.
Down to O'Neal. And Shaq wants to power up with a shot. Does and gets it. Why there was no foul there, I cannot tell you.
Now clearly established as the nation's preeminent player, Shaq found himself routinely swarmed by overzealous opponents.
And Shaquille O'Neal is fouled hard.
Not a tree, you know. I may be tall like one, but, you know, I am a tree. And, you know, gotta keep those guys off me. I don't like people jumping on my back.
They didn't double down. They tripled down. They had three players around him, and he still got the shot off.
The thing that frustrated me was that I was allowed to be pushed, but I couldn't push back. I like getting bumped. I like getting elbowed. I like getting pushed. But if someone's gonna push me, I wanna push them back.
Too big to push back without risking injury to his opponents, Shaq was forced to restrain himself.
Hey, look, you can put your whole bench out there and not stop him. You can put all 12 guys around him.
Though he continued to dominate, his trademark smile was often missing. And as the year came to an end, a difficult decision awaited.
What should I do? Should I come out or should I stay? My father just said, look, you're a man. You handle yourself well. I think you're ready. Whatever you want to do, I'm behind you. He said, if you're not having fun, then it's time to move on.
I, Shaquille O'Neal, after careful deliberation, have decided to forego my senior year of eligibility at LSU. I think the experience was very much needed, but now I'm ready to take what I've learned on with me to the NBA.
Rebound to Barnes. We got a runner. Got a runner.
Few college stars have been as ready to deal with the NBA spotlight as Shaquille was when he left LSU. But the league was changing, and even Shaq couldn't have imagined what awaited him.
Shaq has come along at exactly the right time, when the sport was hungry for a visible figure who could serve as that role model and as that Pied Piper figure, both on the court and off it.
Always comfortable in the public eye, Shaq made the most of his unique opportunity.
Me and my attorney, Leonard Armato, we sat down, we worked out a plan. And before anything, I signed a trading card deal. And then I signed with Kenner Torres. We met with Nike and Reebok, but Reebok gave me the opportunity to have my own shoe line. So I couldn't turn that down.
I just told Leonard Armato to get it done, and we got it done real quick.
Before he played his first professional game, Shaq had turned himself into a brand name. And as he began his NBA career, eyes all over the world turned to Orlando to see if O'Neal could live up to the hype. And amazingly, he would somehow manage to exceed it.
O'Neal the rebound. Now the Magic with a final shot chance. O'Neal runs the floor. O'Neal, oh! O'Neal from Skyle. Look at that.
That's what I wanted to see.
O'Neal.
Oh, boy. Oh! My goodness.
Never a timid rookie, Shaq dominated right from the beginning and hit the NBA with the gale force of a hurricane.
I was taught by my father, never let anyone push you around or dog you out, so to speak. So I had to come in with the vengeance and to let the 26 other teams know that I play hard and I play to win.
Shaq didn't take long to deliver that message loud and clear.
He's a big human being. He's a big, powerful human being.
Oh, Shaquille O'Neal!
The league just hasn't, I haven't seen anything like him ever before.
The Shaq went to the rack, and he took everybody with him.
That was nasty.
People think that just because you're 7 feet, you should have that power. You know, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar didn't come in like that. Even Wilt didn't come in like that. So, I mean, he is unique.
Transition. Oh! Oh, what a dunk! Oh, hey, look at him look back at Mourning.
He is ferocious. He go hard, man. I'm saying, how could a big, usually them big guys, you know, they want to be gentle.
He cannot handle Shaquille O'Neal.
O'Neal, Ewing looks as if he was punched by a right cross.
Oh, you rough.
Not so. O'Neal clearly the villain tonight. Follow jam, and he came with his heavy lumber on that one. Oh, baby.
Every time he got the opportunity to make the other team pay by dunking on their heads, he did it.
Strong. Oh, my. Whoa. That was a manly move.
Oh, that's your.
I think we're going to see a lot of Shaq virus around the league. People are going to come up and say, I don't think I want to play against this guy tonight.
Shaquille did not just overpower the league. He also dazzled it, playing with a style and showmanship that impressed fans every bit as much as his opponents.
The Shaq is putting on a show. He is putting on a show.
No, it's okay to make faces to the crowd, get the crowd going a little bit.
And even Shaquille was impressed with that one. Oh, my.
Try to have fun.
He's this massive Hulk, but when he turns that smile on, he becomes this endearing person. You know, it's this dichotomy of personalities. Is he this big, mean, 7 foot, you know, guy, or is he just this little pussycat?
Hi, Mom, Dad, Grandma, love y'all.
We'd be stretching, let's say, right before practice, and all of a sudden he'd start doing a break dance, and I mean, out of nowhere, and you know, just break everybody up.
I mean, he's born for that. I mean, he's just, to him, that's, the entertainment is the game, Shaq.
Look at Shaq, look at his face.
Yeah.
It's just something that goes through me. I don't know what it is. I can't control it.
I think he loves entertaining people, and he can go out and not be afraid to mask his talents, really let who he is shine through. And do it without any veneer or without any hypocrisy.
But Shaq didn't just entertain on the court. He had a performer's feel for the camera as well.
S-H-A-Q-I-E-M-O-U-S-E.
Let's reenact it for just a little bit. I know I don't look like Bill Russell, but what's the password?
Don't fake the funk on a nasty dunk. Bye.
Great coach, Shaquille O'Neal.
When I was doing a column on him his rookie year, he called me, which was, first of all, unique. And every answer, I was more amazed what kind of kid he was. You know, he was messing with me the whole time we were doing this thing. It was totally unrehearsed, totally spontaneous.
I think if I ever stop having fun, tell me to do something else, like take over your job.
You think you could do my job?
Yeah.
You probably help its creativity.
For real.
Right. Yo, it's on?
Oh, it's on.
Make sure it's on.
All right, what's up?
Before anybody talks to me, they have the sign right here. Just, come on, just the sign right there.
Now, I know this is a gag, so. Ah! Oh, no, man!
He thrived on being a public person, being accessible to the media. And there were times, and I spoke to him often about it during the course of the year, that if this was getting too much for him, that I would do, along with the organization, anything we could to tone it down. But he said, no, I kind of like this. You know, it kind of keeps me going, keeps my adrenaline going. And I kind of felt him getting a boost from all of the, quote, distractions outside.
Shaq's long Saturdays of watching television while he was growing up were now paying off. He had followed popular culture for years, and now he was ready to become part of it.
Someone asked me who my favorite rap group was. I said Fouche Nickens. Then they asked me to come rap with them on the Arsenio Hall show. I did. Can we rock? Yeah, what's up, Doc?
Can we rock? It was phenomenal. Like, every the next day, their phones lit up at the job. Everybody was like, oh, Shaquille, did you see Shaquille? Now slam it down and make sure it's broke.
Yeah. I guess Jive, record company, like what they saw, and they offered me a little record deal.
1 million albums. First professional athlete ever.
Shaq was now in demand for his skills on and off the court.
Nick Nolte, Mary McDonald, and Shaquille O'Neal.
I remember telling my husband, and I have a scene with this guy. He's, I guess, a really great basketball player. He's very young.
Neon, please try not to step on the children.
Okay, all right.
My husband said Shaquille O'Neal. I said, yeah, that's him.
Shaq had begun to blur the line between athlete and entertainer.
You know, everywhere that we go on the road, it's like traveling with a rock star, because the crowds of people gather. It's amazing.
It's immense. I mean, I have a home in Indiana in a very remote area, and I thought, you know, I'll get away, you know. And so I go back and I run down to the little corner grocery store. It's a town where there isn't even a stop sign. It's so small. Going to the grocery store, and there's a life-size poster of Shaquille O'Neal. I mean, it's crazy.
He is a worldwide phenomenon. And really, overnight, he became that person. And it's just this train, you know, express train going down the track, and it just continues to gain momentum.
Thank you. In one whirlwind year, Shaq had created an unprecedented media sensation. But as he reached a new plateau of popularity, he exposed himself to new doubts.
Everybody was thinking, well, Shaq's making albums, Shaq's doing this, you know. What about his game? What about his basketball game, you know?
Doing this movie. I'll be doing commercials. I'll be going to Europe.
Why not be shooting free throws when you're shooting the movie, you know? Or why aren't you working on another move when you're doing the rap album?
Shaquille O'Neal has a $40 million contract to play basketball. He also raps, acts, and has a new Shaq attack. But some say this 21-year-old is doing too much.
George Gervin said one thing one time about Shaq is that, you know, you can't do both of them. You can't rap and you can't play basketball. So he's going to have to make a decision on whether he wants to play basketball or do he want to be a rap singer.
Well, all those Shaq bashers out there said Shaq had no finesse. They say Shaq had nothing but a dunk shot.
Everybody has a black on Shaquille. Well, Shaquille is good, but...
They said he spent too much time on movies and rap albums.
Well, Shaquille can do this, but...
The man's only 22 years old. He's got a rap album.
Where were you when you were 22?
I was out on the court trying to improve my game.
But while it now became fashionable to question his dedication, Shaq never lost sight of his priorities.
My plans of being a professional basketball player, I did not say to myself, I'm gonna be a rapper too, I'm gonna be an actor too. Those things just came my way, and I just took advantage of those opportunities. And I just said to myself, I'm gonna stop reading articles, I'm gonna stop looking at the articles. I was a good player, I played hard. All the other things are irrelevant.
And as the 1994 season began, he took the court ready to prove the skeptics wrong.
My second year, I just said to myself, as long as I'm with this team, with this organization, I have to improve every year.
And from the outset, he showed that this season's model came complete with a new offensive arsenal.
Minute 30 left. Feed from O'Neal Hardaway. Oh, baby.
Gets seven, nice spin, and he puts it home.
Boy, he's playing a game on a different plateau right now.
If you merely just watch the tapes of year one to year two, you'll see a totally different basketball player offensively.
Shaq fights his way through, slides past the basket, and hits.
Well, this guy is making giant strides.
Oh, yeah.
His first year, you know, he'd catch it. For only thing he wanted to do is just take it to the rim and dunk it. You know, I think he worked a little bit. He added a little bit of a jump hook. He had a little bit better moves down in the post.
And he's gotten better, folks. Just think in another couple years what it'll be like.
Now scoring almost at will, Shaq promptly quieted his critics.
I thought there was a lot of Shaq bashing that was unjustified. I really don't believe that everybody understands, you know, what type of work he did during that first summer. Even when he was on location shooting the movie and in the studios recording, he took the first 2 hours of every day to work on his basketball game.
By February, Shaq had been elected to his second starting berth on the All-Star team, and Orlando was perched in second place, trailing only the New York Knicks in the Atlantic Division standings. The young Magic now faced their first true playoff run, and Shaq was ready to put the team on his shoulders.
This is not a guy who, you know, kind of has to take it or leave it, you know, give me my $20 million a year for my salary and endorsements or whatever, and you know, let me go on with my life. I mean, he wants to win.
Shaq was intent on carrying the Magic into the NBA elite, and he made it clear that he would not easily be denied.
Hardaway spins away from Workman, whips to O'Neal, a lot of contact, trickled off the iron. Ball loose, O'Neal saves to himself, leads in left hand, ripped it out. Oh, what hard work by the big fella.
Great work. I mean, that's just great work.
If you're down by one and the ball is like by the end line, and it's only one way to go after it, and that's to dive on the floor, got to do it.
And with Shaq setting the example, the Magic defended their playoff hopes with ferocious determination.
I mean, when you see the star doing it, I mean, you got to say as the, you know, second or the 12th man is, you know, if Shaquille can do it, I know I have to do it.
I think Shaq is really, he's been a real leader here tonight. His efforts, outstanding.
He took me on his wing. You know, like if things were wrong, he'd tell me. If I played good, he'd come up and say, man, you played good. You know, and that meant a lot to me. You know, I never told him, but it did mean a lot to me when he was doing that.
Oh, he's on a mission.
29 points and 11 rebounds.
While other young teams might have faded in the stretch, Shaq assured that the Magic wouldn't.
in practice sometime around March, we would ask him to take some days off of practice, and he just shakes his head and say no. And, you know, me being a player, I just figured he would hit the wall at some point, but he never did.
And as the season drew to a close, it was clear that Shaq's hard work had paid off. The Magic had their best season in franchise history and their first trip to the postseason.
The crowd rises as one. The Orlando Magic have 150.
While Shaq earned consideration as the game's best player,
I hope Shaq stands up and gives a bow. He's well deserved, and he does.
Shaq had capped his remarkable season in style. But the playoffs were now at hand, and a tough Indiana Pacer team awaited.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Magic Basketballs. The Magic tonight will see postseason playoff action for the very first time.
Flushed with their late season success, the Magic confidently prepared for their playoff debut.
We were real confident. We just said we beat Indiana before. You know what we had to do. We were well prepared, and we just went out and played.
And as game one began, Shaq staked the Magic to an early lead.
Flips it up, Davis rejects. O'Neal catches, two to shoot, whips it to Rollins, yes!
Woo! Man. Everyone on Orlando making the extra pass. Beautiful basketball.
Rebound knocked out, Workman lost to Hardaway. Here is Shaq, baby!
But in the second half, the Magic's enthusiasm would begin to yield to the experience of the Pacers.
Miller with the lead for Davis. Beautifully timed.
Turnover-itis starting to catch up to the Magic. Only a 6-point game.
With time winding down, Orlando suddenly found their lead cut to 2, and the Pacers looking for some last-second heroics.
Scott rips it over to Miller. 5 seconds left in the game. Open Byron Scott for three, gone! Byron Scott hits a three, and the Indiana Pacers have stolen one from the Orlando Magic, 89-88.
With one shot, the Pacers had stolen Orlando's home court advantage and their hard-earned momentum.
He was beside himself after game one because I think it really took the confidence away from the team. They knew they were in trouble at that point. They were very young. They were vulnerable. And he knew how bad it was.
In game two, Shaq's worst fears would be realized. Though he tried single-handedly to will Orlando to victory, his good intentions would backfire.
A season low of 15 points for Shaquille O'Neal.
Indiana just double-teamed him and hung on him. That's the way the playoffs are. But I think it was frustrating for him because we were expected to just to go right through that series.
The Indiana Pacers take a 2-0 lead in this best of five series.
As the series shifted to Indiana for game three, the Pacers looked to complete their sweep, and even Shaq could do nothing to stop them.
Here's Miller. Indiana leads.
He was doing everything he could do offensively and defensively to try to help pull the team through, but it just couldn't be done.
The Pacers have won it.
Indiana to move on for the first time in the history of this franchise.
Well, I think there was a high level of frustration. He was very emotional after the loss in Indianapolis. It hurt him very deeply, and he showed it.
He felt that, you know, everything was his fault, of course, because he is our star on the team. He is the man, so to speak. And I think he took a lot of it on his shoulders while we lost. We're kind of upset. We didn't go as far as we would have liked to have gone. And I was a little bitter about that. So we just had to, shake it off and just say to myself, gotta come back next year harder.
Smoking
in Fuego. Bump is showtime.
Chris Paul, what an electrifying talent.
NBA Cares, NBA players are able to make a lasting impact, whether we're building homes or playgrounds for kids and families, stressing the importance of education, or encouraging young people to lead an active, safe, and healthy lifestyle. Our goal is the same, to help strengthen and improve our communities. On behalf of the NBA and all of its players, I'm Kobe Bryant of the Los Angeles Lakers. The NBA, where caring happens.
Shaq would have little time for consolation. He had been named to Dream Team 2. And now he was off to Toronto to participate in the World Championship of Basketball. Playing for a talent-laden USA basketball team, he could easily have gone through the motions, but Shaq threw himself fully into the task at hand.
He set the tone for our training camp early when I taxed the players and I pushed them, and he was right out there in the front leading the laps as we took them and things like that. That really helped me a lot.
You know, you expect big guys, make a lot of money, get a little spoiled, be young and a little bit immature, but the guy worked as hard or harder than anybody on the team.
Look for the ball, Shaq. Get a body out. Get a body out.
Those are, you know, big, strong guys that you have to practice against every day. And we went hard at it for a whole month.
Leaving his playoff disappointment behind, Shaq contributed more to the team than just his work ethic.
Check out this body.
Come on, hey, come on.
Come on, man.
Get out of here. What are you doing?
He certainly was the life of the party every time we were together in a group setting.
He's just a fun guy to be around. He's very talented. He keeps you laughing. He tells stories. He raps. Everybody knows he's a rapper.
Man, at 1:30, wake up at 8:30. They're talking dirty.
He just make up raps as he goes.
Zo, I need a hard beat.
Need that beat, man. Last go round.
Zo would give the beatbox, you know, the with his mouth.
He went down the line and said a rap about every particular player on our team.
I watched me bust this like Dave Justice took Halle Berry from me. Yes, he did, dummy. I got him like Reggie. Pull my drawers, former Reggie. Old man Derek like Coleman. Larry like Johnson. Charles like Bronson. Don't pick Riff. Bring more heat than Steve Smith. I bring more thunder than Dan Marley. Cause I'm not sorry. Bring that beat back. I'm talking like
crap.
Don't sing the national
anthem. That's it, Dave. Keep going, Shaq. Keep going. Keep going.
He kept everybody loose. It was fun being around him. He's just a fun guy, and he's a big kid. He's a big teddy bear, and you can't help but like it being around a guy like that.
When it came time to take the floor, however, Shaq was ready. And nobody was more focused.
1, 2, 3, go!
I know that everyone expected us to win, but there was a lot of people waiting for us to lose. So we had to play extra, extra hard, and we had to do everything right.
And again, the United States looks to run. One.
his own version of the slam dunk competition.
They have no answers for that. Just give Shaquille the ball.
If you get in his way and he's coming in there like that, they could get hurt. No, really. They could get hurt.
Shaq, look at this. The power. Oh, Shaquille O'Neal.
Does the team get worked up on the bench when Shaq goes in one of those killer dunks?
You see everybody jump up and down.
Watch this. Look out. Coast to coast.
The game just totally turns around when Shaq's in the game.
Showcasing his unique blend of force and flair, Shaq left his international audience in awe.
Look out, here comes Shaquille. Shaquille O'Neal.
Even on a team of the league's biggest stars, Shaq had naturally emerged as a leader. And now he took on the role of global spokesman with equal ease.
It was a little bit more hectic because there was international media there, but we were all there for the same cause. That was to win a gold medal and represent the USA. And we did it, and we did it well.
What a move by Shaquille O'Neal!
There's just no one that physically can even come close to challenging him.
And the United States has won the gold. And that man, Shaquille O'Neal, was unstoppable right throughout the tournament, named most valuable player.
It was a good honor to my family, my organization, and my team members. It meant a lot to me, too. Dream team, too. Good feeling.
Through NBA Cares, the NBA family demonstrates its responsibility as citizens of the global community. Whether it's our Basketball Without Borders program that takes us all over the world, or our efforts to strengthen and improve communities here at home, we work to leave a lasting impact every place we go. It's our way of showing that the NBA cares. On behalf of the NBA and all of its players, I'm Ray Allen of the Boston Celtics. The NBA, where caring happens.
And Shaq has succeeded in facing each new challenge that his ever-growing popularity has presented, from acting as a role model to his throngs of fans, to playing ambassador to legions of NBA converts abroad. He's handled it all with effortless grace and joy.
This is how people try to get at me. Look.
But as Shaq's runaway celebrity has gained a momentum of its own, so too have people's expectations.
Can he be the best center ever? Can he become that?
He no longer competes only with his nightly opponents, as experts already debate how many championships he can win and measure him against the toughest standard of all, that of history.
He's a force, and old-timers, even older than me, don't want to admit it, but this is Wilt in the 90s. Get used to it, folks, because that's what he is.
And even for those long used to the spotlight, that kind of pressure can take its toll.
When you're dealing with success, there's always going to be higher expectations from year to year. But I think what's very important to Shaquille is he must set his own expectations and live up to those, because I believe if he lives up to his own expectations, he's going to surpass any other expectations that people may have for him.
And so far, Shaq has managed to do exactly that.
He's going to take the three, and he hit it. The big fella hits a bomb.
None of these surprises me now, you know. Whatever, none of this, he just surprises me.
And it's the first time someone has actually come out and averaged almost 30 points a game, 13 rebounds, 4 or 5 blocks a game, play every single game, take your team to the playoffs, made a movie, made a rap album, made a home video. Maybe he is Superman.
But even more than superpowers, what Shaq will need most is his sense of perspective. As he continues to chart new territory in the realm of superstardom, it will be easy for him to lose his way. But once again, Shaq seems well prepared. For if there's one ability that he has possessed from childhood, it is an unyielding sense of who he is and where he is going.
His style of making the most out of the situation, he has incredible marketing instincts. You know, recently he jammed his toe in practice, and so he shows up the next day and he had painted his toenails red.
That's a new look for me. I think red is my color.
Shaq doesn't have to act like a personality. He just is a personality. And so he's really just being himself. And so all those things just go along with being Shaquille O'Neal.
Thanks, Shaq. Thanks for the hat, man.
You're welcome. I did an interview with him out in California, and I said to him, how, at age 22, are you so mature, you're able to deal with all this adoration, all the pressures? And, you know, his answer was that it's just, he does it by common sense.
He understands who he is. He's very well grounded, and he's a guy who's gonna make the NBA proud for a long time.
He's a young man who knows where he came from, why he's here, where he's headed. But I think above all, he understands the importance of seizing the moment, of seizing the day.
I'm a real simple person, and I don't think about what's going on, don't read my own articles, don't forget where I come from.
Because this thing that's going on right now, it's not gonna go on forever. So you just have to, you know, stay real.
Of being a shill, now I know why they say we love this game.
We love this game.
What a, it's just unbelievable.
Now the final second of play here in the Boston Garden. Boston up by 2. Won't start till it's clutched. They'll have to throw it up. Garhood, turnaround, shot in the air. It's good. It's tied again. I don't believe it. Garfield heard at the buzzer. We've got a third overtime in a Boston Garden.
Take a breather. Garfield Hearn made the basket. I want to tell you something. Somebody up there is on our side.
5 seconds left. Boston only has a 1-point lead.
Greer's putting the ball in play. He gets it out deep, and Havlicek steals it.
The Celtics 113-111.
Well, they're going to try and make a steal here, and they got their best defensive team in there right now.
And the Lakers, keep in mind, do not have to take a shot.
This goes quickly in now to Magic. Back over to Worthy, and it's picked off. Going to heavens, and he lays it off and out. It's all tied up. A great play by heavens.
For a minute there, I could hear Johnny Bruce going,
Henderson, steal the ball.
Whenever you're ready.
Blue Chips, my movie.
Shaq Fu to return. My next Smash CD. And this is my new Shaq trainer. And now, check out my new video.
Sometimes I rhyme slow, sometimes I rhyme quick. Wake up in the morning, shave my head with Bic Trip. So I could live happily ever after. Right now I'm setting that up by being Hooper / rapper. But there's so many obstacles, no time to kill. Pass the pill so I can pay my bills. You see, I checked myself back in 93. Can't nobody be me but me.
Bangs into a double team, dunks. Mason had it blocked. O'Neal blocks it again.
Can't nobody be me but me. Fame and fortune, fortune and fame. Walking down the street, brothers know my name. But I can't get caught up in the act. No matter what you say about me, I'm still the same old Shaq. Age 22, I can't cope. My name is on the walk of fame like Bob Hope. No mistakes allowed when I'm in the crowd. Lucille said, hang your head, but hang it proud. Like the Denise Williams, gotta be free. I surely can't be you, so I'ma be me. Nobody be me but me.
O'Neal, lob from Scott.
Can't nobody be me but me. Don't be alarmed, cause Shaq drops the bombs. I'm setting up car alarms from here to Vietnam. I got you gifted, mad and upset. Age 22, own private jet. The things you say don't make no sense.
This right here is a knucklehead ritual. This right here is called the tight fade slap. Every time you get a tight fade, you gotta get a slap. I'm first.
Right?
Yeah.
What's up, baby?
A lot of guys in the league getting ball heads. I didn't want to look like them, so I came with a new style, the Isaac Hayes Shaft look. That's nothing but the side, but under the side. And I always touch them up for good luck. You want to touch them up then? I call it the Steve Koontz theory. Let's just go out, play hard, do your job, try to have fun, try to intimidate the other opponents.
Were you looking to put on? Wrap it up.
Make sure I ain't no pigeons up there.
Like a gigantic Urkel.
Can I do, man? Can I do, man?
Do you want me to shoot it?
No.
For you guys, you were so disappointed.
Do you want me to pass it? Do you want me to slam? Entertainment was at Shaq's house yesterday. Shaq told me himself. My name is Pinky Lee, by the way. This is my restaurant. You need to come by. It's on Amelia. You know where it's at. Pinky Lee's. Come by, get your good old meal.
How do you know Shaq?
I know him. Yeah, 10 minutes. Thank you. Is it free? Oh, it's free? Okay. Make it 20 minutes then. Take your time. If it's free, take your time. Okay? And remember, I ordered the big breakfast. You see these sideburns? He got them for me. He saw me with these sideburns. He was trying to hit on me, but I wouldn't give him no play. But he saw my sideburns, and he just wanted to have the sideburns just like me.
So why didn't you give him any play?
Because I'm married. My husband's right there. Colton, come here, please. That's my husband.
I'll be OK. I'll be back. Shaq will be back. See ya.